that opening night in October 2011. The game is on. Cam York sends it deep. Pasternak, a quick re-entry, tries to dangle Zamula. Two on one, Garnet Hathaway, and Ryan Poehling on a one-timer. Philadelphia leads.
Well, you got to believe that the Flyers, and if they're going to make the postseason, they need to play like this. They create the turnover in the defensive zone. They get a quick counter with numbers. Boston thinking offense. The Flyers had really a line change in progress for themselves. But because they end up with possession of the puck, Bruins thinking Pasternak's going to make a play with it. And now you got everybody moving in the wrong direction when that puck goes.
Peek to Geeky. Lawton into the Boston zone. Konechny and two saves by Swayman. Mark throws down. Dick DeBrusk. Morgan Geeky scores! What a sequence! Two saves by Swayman at the other end, and Geeky lights the lamp.
That puck maybe start a breakout the opposite direction. Big time save by Swayman with the left pad. And then DeBrusk takes over. We talked about him in the open, the great speed. He just pulls away off the board side, left side, and just gets his feet moving, crossing over, picking up speed. He gains entry, and he draws three Flyers to him.
In fighting majors. Konechny. At the bottom of the circle, sizzles a pass past Frost. Farabee on the elbow. Yields to Tippett. York, a wrist shot tipped in front by Joel Farabee. It's an even strength goal in the vulnerable minute.
What essentially is a power play. Try to stay in that shooting lane. Don't cheat to one side because there's a power eye in front of the net. I mean, you know, all the Bruins on the outside of the shooting lane, but there's two Flyers with an opportunity to screen, tip, redirect.
Marchand to Coyle. It's tied.
Bruins doing a nice job in the faceoff circle on this power play, and they get rewarded for it. This is not a clean win back, but it's a second effort win by Pavel Zacha. And it's a deflection in the direction of Brad Marchand. You watch the way the Flyers react when this puck goes towards the hash mark. They try to sniff out the puck. It looked like Mark Stahl was the guy who was going to get possession, so he vacates that part of the area of the defensive zone, which is the most dangerous, the inside hash. Both he and Konechny looking at that puck, looking to make a play. Konechny loses his stick. Stahl tries to lay out. Brad Marchand with a beautiful little tuck backhand as if he made.
Boston has scored four goals, four on four this season, and allowed three. Philly, Lawton chasing. Peek to Lindholm. Down into the corner to Pasternak. Coyle with speed. Oh, he roofs it! The Bruins lead for the first time tonight. Charlie Coyle with his second of the game.
The Bruins are changing out, and if you're Flyers, it's so hard to defend. When somebody comes off the bench fresh, you feel like you're in man-to-man, but nobody really knows who's going to pick up Coyle coming off the bench. And all he's got to do is find a seam, hang on to the puck, attack the net. He's had such an advantage because of where he's coming from, and everybody's in man-on-man in a four-on-four situation, but it's the finish. It's the finish that you got to love. Close range.
Sanheim sweeps it into the Boston end. Peek to Boqvist, a cutback. Peek, and Beecher on the rebound! Off the post and in!
Dump it back in the defensive zone, and he finds Boqvist at the far blue line. So it's a stretch pass. Boqvist makes a nice play to go to the middle of the ice. It allows Peek to come down, fill the lane. And Peek makes a great pass to a wide open Beecher. His first shot catches the post. And then his second backhand is up in the air. Yeah, it's already crossed the goal line. Sure looked that way to me, Jack, from the overhead. Yep. The puck had already broken the plane.
2 minutes, 37 seconds, and a nearly third goal in succession by Lindholm. DeBrusk, oh, he tucks it in! Couturier makes a good play. Frederick blocked by Atkinson. Couturier spoons the backhand into Lindholm's corner. And Delorier scores past Swayman. It's 5-3 with 5:48 to go.
And at this point in the season, when you're looking for points,
Nicholas Delorier with his first goal in 64 games.
Yeah, the Bruins are in pretty good shape. They got bodies back, but it's a nice play by Couturier below the goal line, behind the Bruin net, and that's always a tough read for the goaltender. It's on the blind spot. Delorier able to slip around. There's Couturier. Slip around Lindholm, then he got a little bit of inside position.
Into the Ford F-150 final five. Frost to tip it, down to Frost, and he makes the circus move to cut the lead to one. 4:46 to go.
Serves a good purpose for the Boston Bruins to collect yourselves, talk about things, how to finish this game off, secure the 2 points.
Sanheim, Beaky pressures, York off Heinen's stick, Hathaway centers, Sanheim, a shot blocked, Heinen with Geeky, the trailer, and Heinen picks the post and scores!
Well, the Bruins defend well enough. Anxious moments, because it was a one-goal game. But they defend well enough to finally get an opportunity to make a play with the puck. Danton Heinen taking no chances. He had Frederick coming, but the play wasn't there. Maybe the drop pass was available. I think it was Geeky that was trailing. And he goes for the shot, and it is a beauty. Over the glove, under the crossbar.
Konechny back to Zamula off DeBrusk's stick. York around behind Swayman's goal. Barby with the wraparound, and it's 6-5. What did we go through, a wormhole back to the late 80s?
Boston's had leads in the third period, have a difficult time closing. The shot from the sideboards is deflected, and it throws off the rhythm of Swayman trying to attack the shot. We'll get a look at it. Barabee, Konechny, the redirect by Tippett, and now Swayman can't recover. The puck goes right back.
5 seconds to play. The Bruins move into first place, 1 point ahead of Florida. The Panthers have a game in hand.